title before it's shouted at. Cruise Commuting Part 1 by Mr. TrainCow. So Acela Express on New York, New Haven. So the Acela's not on sale at the moment. I believe it's coming back, but don't quote me on that, please. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, I did update eventually. Hello, driver. You are driving the Acela Express down to New York. There are many passengers there. They're embarking service to get to the cruise terminal. Start by opening the doors and here at New Haven. It's a three-part of this one. Excellent. By the way, driver, you're running... Well, I've only just started the scenario. Apparently, I'm already running late. What I am going to do is just pause the game real quick. And I'm going to just... go into here, cab image viewer, match that to what looks good. Don't have an Acela. Well, that's a fail. We'll just do that one, I think. It's kind of American, and you can barely tell the difference from the back cabs a lot of these locos unless you know what you're doing. Right. Limit till we get our first signal indication, and then we should get updated. Yep, we've been updated to a line speed of 30 on a green signal. Oh, double ACS 64 coming in the other direction there. Do I like the New York New Haven route a lot? Well, I didn't. It's one of those things where I haven't run it for ages, and now I'm going through a period of running it possibly too much. I do like the route, but then I was part of the team that made it, so. Speed limit's 50. Oh, hello. Got some stuff going on over here. Suddenly dropped to 45. Back up to 50 again. Tutorials for creating lofts? No, I'm not aware of any of those. How do I pronounce Pullman? Pullman. Right, we have a signal indicate speed limit of 45. One minute into the scenario and already speeding. That's not a record. I've been speeding pretty much the minute I put the throttle on before now. Speed limit's gone up, but we are still stuck at 45. I should probably slow down to 45. About to go over signal, we might get a drop or a speed increase. I guess it depends if we're following something. If we're following something, this drop to 55 should have given them plenty of time to pull away again. We should get a normal. We did, so up to 70. Apparently you can't just throttle up on this. A wee bit light-footed. Wanted. Tilt system's activated. That's not permitted on this line. Tilt system has to be isolated on this line. There's not enough clearance between the tracks to run the tilt system. This train is really interesting because the tilt system only works on the coaches. The train doesn't tilt. I'm tilting at the moment because it's super elevation. That's fine. But tilt that you think of on a Pendolino, proper tilting trains, that only actually happens on the coaches. The train is like this and the coaches tilt behind it. What's a tilt system? It's the thing that makes the train tilt round corners. So the Acela can do tilting like the Pendolino can do tilting. But it's only the coaches that do that. The power car doesn't tilt. Which I was really surprised, but it is true. Mr. Steelman, any idea why when pressing P the power source won't change over? Oh, you mean the third rail to overhead? You need to look down the bottom left on the cab in the desk, and there's a DC and something else overhead, a button. So you DC and CTRL, I think it is. So put the panto down, press the button to change it, and then press P to put them back up again, or drop the shoes if you're going to DC. I've got a video on how to drive the 395 that explains all of that stuff. Still clear up to 70. You want to fly by? Oh, Globitz, yes, he says, is it possible to edit one of the scenarios that come with the route and just change the loco we're driving? Yes, there is, and I have a video that shows you precisely how to do that. It's dead easy. The other thing you have to remember, Mr. Steelman, is Arnold Acerimer. Woot, don't see enough of this wonderful loco on Steam. Nice to see you being an engineer in it. They are engineers, not drivers. That is exactly correct. You don't drive a train in America. You operate or run a train in America. And you're an engineer. Can I get some GGs for Arnold Acerimer, please? Thank you very, very much, Arnold, as always. Yeah, Mr. Steelman, sorry. When you you press the change the power. So if you're in CTRL, press DC. Then you press the pan up button. Press the pan up button again. So the first time it brings it, it will raise it, but you'll get a line fault. Then when you press it again, it resets the breakers, and then you'll be good to go. You have to remember to press it twice. You see the white light on the top left corner of the desk will tell you when the light is on. I think it's when your breakers are need resetting. Press it again and it is when that goes off, something like that. I can't remember it off the top of my head. See you later, Sound Train. We're still running at speed limit here, and by the way I'm going, I really will be losing the getting down to zero. The challenge at this point is to not get down to zero. doesn't pressing Y change the power source? Possibly. I must admit, I like pressing the buttons on the dash. Y possibly does it. Y does it on a number of other trains, so it might do. Dr. Anthony, I will be going back to Subnautica once the major patch goes out. Once the major patch goes out, then yes, I will be. Then we'll have things like the exosuit, the revised interior. I think they'll pretty much be at the point where they're about finished, so we'll actually see whether there's an end game. Take it a bit further. Right, 30 limit. Massive drive quality penalty points here. Yeah, I'm using the Logitech C920, I think that a lot of streamers use. Right, we've got 45. We gained some points back, we didn't make it to zero. Almost made it to zero. Globitz, it's something like how to change a loco or something like that. Let me see if I can find you the list. So we're on signal reduction at the moment of 45. Static crackle. Okay, driver, there's a problem. What is it? Coupling came off a raking cement cars. How did the cars get on the same line? They went over when we were changing the junction. So, what's the plan? You're going on the slow line, so we're back. Roger that. I clearly don't read as fast as you, Mr. Trinko. Dispatch out. Still on a 45 limit. Yeah, a lot of streamers use the C920. It's a really, really good camera, and these days it's a very good price as well. Dave, can we please, please, please stop with the awful yokes? How many legs does a horse have? If you said four, you're wrong, as they have six. Front legs are four legs, and rear legs are two. Four plus two equals six. Very good, very good. Thank you very much, Dave. Going to get some GGs for Dave. Thank you very much, Dave. He says, can we stop with the awful yokes, and then gives us one that's possibly worse than all the rest. GG. See the GG? Did anyone get that? Can we get some GGs for the horse joke? Right, 40 limit. Here a week, and you got one involving cats as well. Would Moggy be offended though? Oh, something's occurring up here. Oh, hello. That's in a bad way, isn't it? Let's pause that and what's going on here? Oh dear. He's looking a bit confused. What's happening? That's not possible. Nicely done. Favorite stick local, the 90th. Shazen, if there's you can't do it with all locos. If the loco's available in a as a scenery asset, then you can place it pretty much wherever you like. But it's actually there aren't that many locos placed in all the scenery assets. New York New Haven does come with the AEM-7 as a low poly model, so you can place that. What's wrong with the microphone? It says it's going out alright. I have started looking at alternative microphones. I've sort of priced it all up on Amazon. So I just need to bite the bullet and buy it. You just have to make do with one of the big pop mic in front of my face. Sound will be awesome and you won't have to look at my face anymore, so Moggy and Dave will be happy. Probably reconnect the microphone. It's plugged into the back of the PC, that's what it's going to happen. Plug out the USB device. That would upset OBS and you'd never get audio again without restarting OBS. It's not USB, it's a regular mic. It's still weird. I don't know why it would sound weird. Something like underwater. Oh well, there's not a lot I can do about that at the moment. Still limited to 45. Anti-noise removal. That's bizarre. I mean, all I did was just move the microphone closer to my mouth. I suspect the microphone on this is possibly suffering somewhat. So, I need to get myself a new mic. I'm going to get a proper studio mic and then boom things to hold it. That should increase the quality of the audio significantly. Still stuck at 45. Louder now, but still distorting. Yeah, it's the Rode Podcaster I'm looking at using. Go into the Sound Blaster settings and see if it's decided to do something it's not supposed to.
What about now? I mean, all the background noise is on now. Is the microphone any... You've got lots of noise now, but I've just turned off all of the noise cancellation on the Sound Blaster that's always been there. One of those boom things. Yeah, and a boom standy thing. I'm not making my situation any better here, am I? Oh, you prefer it like this, do you? Much better, but too loud. Cut the volume down a little bit. Now you're all distorted at the high end. Yeah, that's because it's too loud and it's clipping. I've just cut the volume down a bit so it's not clipping anymore. It's still close to your face. Yeah, there is that. Okay, so we've got a 45 limit coming up. Ow. My back. Dave, you're not going to be satisfied till I've cut it all the way down, are you? Let's be honest. Signal speed reduction to 45. Let's get it down. Those buttons above me, I don't entirely sure. They look like some sort of heating or something like that system. Don't breathe through your nose. It's either going to get the one way or the other. Here we go, 15. We're now on a restriction. It's coming up with drive quality penalties even on suppression braking, which you shouldn't do. So I don't know whether or not you've set the penalties too sensitive on this, Mr. TrainCow. Because you should certainly be able to do suppression braking. In fact, you're required to do suppression braking when you get a reduction in the signal. Is it possible to make broad gauge tracks? Yes, it is possible to make broad gauge tracks. In fact, there are broad gauge tracks, though. They were in one of the old 08 packs. Bridgeport is where we're going, I think. I don't know, Bridgeport and then Stamford. How come the reverse is on 99%? It's a bug with my rail driver software. I've written my own all my own rail driver software and I haven't calibrated it properly, so it never gets up to 99%. Alright, we clear back up to 45. Oh, that's bizarre, Mr. TrainCow. Because he never gives 100%. Nice, Shazza, nice! Right, we're stopping at Bridgeport. So we should probably think about that and make sure we, you know, actually do. What happens if you go max throttle? You get lots of penalty points applied for driver quality errors. Your wheel slips a whole lot, and it gradually accelerates. Will it crash? No, not until you go around a corner too quickly, and then it probably will. But we're coming in just about on time. If it ever stops, anyway. How do you prevent wheel slips, sand, and or drop back on your throttle? Morricone, am I doing the 1st of September show? Yeah, it's a special show, and all I'll say is tune in and you'll find out what the show's about on the day. I don't want to give anything away, because it's awesome. Right, heading off now. Stamford, 22 miles, and we are our 45 limit. Is it on my channel, Matt, or DTG? It's on the Dovetail. It's official stream, Gareth. So it'll be on the Dovetail stream. The Dovetail channel. You have school camp on the 1st of September, Victor. That's no problem. You just need to watch it. It'll be probably available on demand, almost certainly available on demand. Right, 30 limit at the moment. I guess you're not serious enough for games. You modify the game files, give the train times 50 acceleration and race through tracks. Other people have done that, Space Fisher, and they quite enjoy doing that. In fact, I did it for my son because he wanted a TGV that could run as an 18 car unit, and he wanted, I think, 3,000 miles an hour. So, yeah, I set that up for him. Nothing stops this TGV now. Nothing, well, except running out of track, that stops the TGV. And going round any kind of corner at all, that stops the TGV quite quickly. What's my favourite American route? This is one of my favourite American routes. This Donner Pass is another favourite. Hey there, homebound train. Oh, the official stream will only be on Facebook. Ah, okay, I didn't realise that. So I'm not involved in the organising of it. As always, I just do as I'm told. Well, mostly. Oh, Globitz. Oh, it doesn't need 3,000 miles long to get up to that, because it's also got much, much higher power, which means it gets up to its top speed incredibly quickly. I haven't watched the DVD yet, Homebound Train, but we're being at Bristol this weekend. I haven't had a chance to sit and do anything, to be honest. Did I read about school in Sussex? No, I didn't, Dave. What's Moggy been up to now? Cat joke from Dave. 8 cats in a boat, 1 jumps out. How many are left in the boat? If you're saying 7, the answer's wrong, because they were all copycats. Ha ha ha! Good, Dave. Oh no, Dave, that's not good. A couple of SD40s. Timings on this scenario are quite good, it has to be said. Part two will be harder, will it, Mr. Trainco? Excellent. We've still got 18 miles to go. Well, I'm sure I'll enjoy a homebound train. I'm looking forward to watching it. Oh, Globitz, I find it ironic the colours red, white and blue stand for freedom until they're flashing behind you. See you tomorrow, Railroad. Yep, same time, same place. Did I watch the Rio Olympics? We watched bits of it. We tend to watch, sort of follow tennis quite a lot in the house. So we watched lots of Andy Murray games and other bits of tennis. Hey there, Shockwave Gamers. Welcome. Still on a 70 limit. We speed up a little bit. Oh, a bench seater, yes, homebound train. Yeah, they're quite nice, aren't they? I think it was a bench seater I had on my one time I've ridden on a Pacer. Shazen, if you have a look at my, I think it's the second rail driver video I did, I covered a number of things, one of which was a suggestion about how you could switch over to use the loco brake instead of using the throttle, and I showed kind of how you could do that with their script, so that might give you a head start, if not do it for you. I can't remember exactly what I did, but it should give you a head start at least. So I have Detective Inspector Knee. In part two, the performance variable notches up. So what you're saying is I'm going to get an even worse score. Stanford the final stop, yep, Stanford is the final stop. I did a part one of this route last week too. Yes, I need to go and have a look for that as well. This scenario was originally scheduled to go out on Thursday last week, so I just bumped it forward, and I think Thursday last week part two, I don't think it was there for the other one. Why does the light next to 70 keep flickering? It's an error of some sort, I think. Bye bye, score. Still got 11 miles to Stanford. Mr. TrainCow, what I would suggest is for part two, you kill off the drive quality errors, because there's seriously, there's not something wrong there. So I would kill off the errors for drive quality, because suppression braking should not cause drive quality errors. So the fact that it is not good situation. But you can abate that by getting rid of the drive quality penalty or turning it down. I think you can turn it down, but I can't remember exactly what control you have over it. I think it may well be that all you can do is just say that the score is zero or the penalty is zero. Good luck for your job interview, Mr. Steelman. Thanks for stopping on. I'll see you in the next time. Bennett125, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Just dropping down to the 45 limit up here. Trying to do it without losing all my score. Ooh, got that timed just about perfectly. How can you locate the way you're going on Google Earth? So I've got another plugin that I've written. It's all actually part of my rail driver software. And it's pulling down the latitude and longitude from the game and then mapping it into Google. Or in this case, it's actually Bing Maps rather than Google. I find Bing Maps data is a bit more consistent. I'm not sure why, because I don't normally use Bing Maps, but that's bizarre, Mr. TrainCow. I don't know why it's more sensitive. The only thing I can wonder is whether or not the... because obviously if they've done any changes to the Acela, whether or not I've got a different version of the Acela. which is a possibility, I guess.
Oglobitz would tell us a chemistry joke, but he knows he wouldn't get a reaction.
Favourite American loco? I really like things like the GP38 and the SD40-2, you know, because they are not... They're still quite powerful locos, but they're not... you still feel a bit... Same as I like to drive little aircraft in... fly little aircraft in flight sim. Because you're still... They're still... You're not too isolated by computers and so forth. I also like the AMD S44, but the... I like... Just the slightly smaller ones, like the Jeep 38 and SD40. Yeah, Mother Dragon. Unfortunately, the Acela is off sale at the moment. Like I said, I believe it's coming back, but I don't know when. Anything that isn't generic looking freight diesel, David. I must admit, I quite like the SD60M because it looks it's sort of got a unique look to it. And that Canadian Pacific SD40 that's got four windows across the front. A quadruclops. Miles to go. See you later, Dave. Thanks for everything. Gareth, thanks for the stream. Need to head to bed. Looking forward to the first to hear the news. Nice. Yeah, thanks for popping in, Gareth. Look forward to seeing you again. B. Harrison, can you test my locomotive knowledge? You can test it. Well, I'm not going to guarantee I'll do any good at it. There are so many locomotives out there. If it's something hard like how many wheels does a 210O have, then I can cope with that. Big Chrome, the line that goes to the Boeing factory. Oh, and Stevens Pass route, you mean. I don't think we're going to get to go to 125 on this journey, train boy. Because we're only going to Stamford. You're going to get the Norfolk Southern High Hood SD45. Nice. Blow the horn. There isn't a passenger view on the Acela, I'm afraid, 60 Train Hunter. You're looking at getting clear creep, we'd like to see more than one loco type. Yeah, I don't know what plans they have for more locos on it. I like it, the clear creep, because of the... you've got the switchback lines going up one way, you've got the loops going the other way. It's just a really interesting, and it's a very challenging drive. Why doesn't the map show the speed limits? How do you mean, train boy? Do you mean, because if the speed limits are done by signals, then they're not on the map. If the speed limits are done by signposts, they should be on the. Do you mean on the? You mean the HUD on the bottom? I take it. Money Lord, yes, I work for Dovetail Games. So that 45 we just came into there is actually a signal aspect, and that signal aspect means 45 miles an hour. So you wouldn't see that on the map because it's not part of the map. You mean the big map? You mean this one? You just don't see speed limits on the number 9 map. I stalled uphill on Clear Creek, I did. Do I like Mr. Bean? Yeah, I used to watch all of his TV show, and I think I watched them. There was one or two movies as well. I like Rowan Atkinson, he's just really good. Some lines in the UK have purple aspects. No, they're French. There's purple aspects on the French line timebound train. Certainly never heard of it in the UK, but there are purple aspects in France. I can't remember what they are now. I think they're used for ground signals. Oh, there's that ACS 64. A few screenshots. There we go. Good job, driver. Grab a sub seat. We'll be here for a while. Don't forget to play part two. Right, we shall not forget to play part two. And we'll be doing that one at some point in the future. Right, so that was Cruise Commuting Part 1 by Mr. Train Cow. And that is the end of Train Sim Live. Now, coming up next is Nebworth Trucking, where I'm going to play Euro Truck Sim 2, running Pro Mods 2.1 for a little while. Right, okay, so let me play the theme tune, go and have a break, and then I'll come back and we'll drive a truck. Alright then, folks, thanks very much for watching. Really appreciate it, and thanks to everybody who gave tips and donations and things. That's just stunning, superb. Thank you very, very much. I'm going to put the theme tune on now, but if you are staying around, don't go away. We'll be doing trucking in just a moment. Alright then, folks, thanks again. See you in a minute.